Hi guys, and thanks for watching again. In this video I will be building the base for this thing. The base is over here. Here's some leftovers from my solder sucker. I'll tell you why that is in a moment. And I'm going to build the main power board over here, and then I'm gonna construct it all together until this thing works. And what I just did, why that is there, I checked if all the LEDs are working, and I did that by plugging in just a simple USB to TTL adapter. I plugged in the ground and the 5 volts. The ground is, in my case, orange, and the 5 volts is yellow. So the 5 volt is yellow, which goes over here, and the ground is orange, which goes over here. Let me see if I can get it in focus. There we go. And on the previous video about this kit, someone called Electrozoix, if I'm pronouncing that correctly, he or she told us, do not mix up the RXD and the TXD of the adapter on there, because he or she did that and it died. So be extra careful when you connect these two. And there's luckily a table over here. It says TTL, which is this thing, and POV, which is this thing. So the RXD of this thing goes to the TX over there, and the TXD of this thing goes on the RX over there. It is logical, of course, but it is also very easy to mix up. So beware when you connect this, it might die. And we don't want that, because this is not the cheapest of the LED kits around. And I'm Dutch, so yeah. Enough said. So I connected it. Let me put it over here. Put it in this cheap, shitty pink power bank. There we go. And I can see all the LEDs are working. And I know that because I just did that. Because, yeah, I wanted to see it before I made this video. And one of the LEDs was not working. And one of the LEDs both were lighting at the same time on this side. And what it is was very simple. I shorted one of these pins over here, which made the two of the LEDs light at the same time, and one of the LEDs on there was not working, although the LEDs itself was perfectly soldered. It looked very nice, so I traced back the line on the board, came with the IC, and I just saw that the pin of the IC was not touching the board very good, or at least the solder was just floating a little bit above the pad of the board. So that is fixed. All the LEDs are working right now. Not sure if it is working while it's spinning, or if it goes in the exact same error mode as the previous kit did. But I'm happy so far. This is going in the good direction, if I may say so. So put this over here, and that's why the solder sucker is and dust is over here, because I sucked away the leftover solder and started all over again. So put this aside, and let's start by building the main board. Not the main board, but the main power supply, if we may call this tiny board that. This one goes on one of the wires, I guess. There's some heat shrink tube LED, infrared LED, more. Some connectors, a switch goes also on a wire, I believe. Huge capacitor for such a small board, IC, and all lots of small units. And there we are. There are markings on the board, so that is good. So let's start with the IC. It's the simple, most obvious component. Let me get the tweezers. And probably let me also speed up the video, because you've seen me do this. You know how this works. So this is boring to watch, so there we go. Now, that's all the components done. Now it's time to add the wires and the specific components on the wires. And I believe I saw in the manual there's a position for a diode over here. And I may short that, so that's what I'm going to do. Although I do still think that this diode is there on the board for a purpose, and they just want me to short it out, probably to save some money, to save the cost of the diode. But of course I'm not sure, it could be a design mistake, but unlikely in my opinion. Or it is to prevent a mix-up of the polarity. But now it is shorted. I will be careful with the polarity. Alright. L1 is over here. Goes to the coil. M goes to the motor. 12 volts goes to this plug. Although I have no power cable for this, but luckily one of my previous kits has. P1 is... Yeah, what is P1? Switch. And the LED is, I must say correctly, this LED. This is the receiver LED, but this is the LED. Going to build the base first, because that determines how long or the wires, or how I should mount the wires. And I will probably twist them around the poles or anything. Not quite sure about that, but if I mount it all on here right now, there is no way for me to fix all the wires on there. So let me first get this nasty stuff off. Right. There, fingerprints. Oh, that's why I said nasty stuff. I hate this stuff. It always tears up. And this is even one of the simpler forms where it shouldn't tear off. Because stuff with indents or anything, they will, it's more likely to tear, but this just also tore, so yeah, probably have to position these poles. And there's some hot melt glue. Nice. Let's get this off too then. Does it matter if I put in these screws on the bottom, or should I put these on the bottom? I think these screws is better, because those are flat and these are not. So going to undo this and do it again with the screws on the bottom. Now, let me get this tiny piece of pliers. There we go. Precision pliers. All right. Because my precision pliers I use over here all the time, they're still missing. I blamed my wife, and she said she didn't do it. I doubt it, to be honest, but yeah, it just went missing from one of the previous days. Out of the blue, it's probably on vacation or something, I don't know. I'll get me a new set of pliers. Oh, the motor, I'm forgetting the motor. Ooh. One moment, I'll fix the motor. Now I'm making sure that it is not very tight, these screws, because see if I can get the screw in focus. As you can see, it is somewhat angled at the bottom of the screw head, which means if I tighten it very fast, it will drive all the plastics outside and it will probably crack or something, which it probably will, because these holes are not aligned very nice. Now, I do not have a ruler within reach, but I do have this. It is the only advantage of the edge, 3.5 centimeters. 3.5 centimeters, so that makes no difference. There you saw the only advantage of the edge of one of the Samsung phone. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to get my hot glue gun again. And I'm going to heat this up with a flame. Not very much, because I don't want the plastic to melt. I just want it to be warm, so that the hot glue does not instantly cool down as soon as I apply it. Because, yeah, I just hate hot glue. I absolutely hate it. But for this application, it is just fine. So there we go. Yeah, let me warm it up. I'll be back in a moment. While this gun is warming up, I'm going to fix one of the LEDs. So what I'm going to do, turn the longer lead, the positive. There we go. Add some extra tin on there. Let's see if I can get them together. Yes. Now the reason I'm doing it like this, now I can cut the both leads and still know which one is the positive and which one is the negative. Of course, you can also see it by the large anvil inside, but that is correct most of the time, but not all the time. See if I can push the LED in. There we go. No. Also making sure that it is not getting too hot, not only for the plastic to melt, but also of the wiring of the of the coil. I don't want these wires to melt together. Here you see why I hate this stuff so much. Oh, it is just terrible. Absolutely terrible. It looks terrible. Working with it is terrible, and it makes these tears, these wires, these nasty, nasty stuff. Some people love it. I hate it. I need to warm the gun every time. Only advantage is that it is dried within seconds. And now it is refixable. So if I made a mistake, I can cut it loose and fix it again. And with some epoxy glues or resins, I cannot. And now it is everywhere, this nasty, nasty stuff. But the coil is in place and it is in the center. And there is some hot melt glue on there. Nice. Right. Wires of the coil. Now, and where is the LEDs? It's getting loose again. Let me. Now it fell on the ground. The hole is a bit too large. Let me see if I can get the. Or the hole is a little bit more tight. A little bit. Let me see if the gun is warm enough. It is. That should keep it in place. I love this stuff. I want the wires to go between these columns so that the turning thing doesn't hit it. And of course that goes for these wires too, but these have to connect first. Let's thin that some more. Actually first create them equal length, because I can't handle this. There we go. Ooh, that smells nice. Burning insulation of enameled wire. Nice. Now let's connect them first, because otherwise I will mix them up. But of course I will have to mount these on the board first. Why did I forget that? Now, two things about these connectors. As soon as you put these white blocks on there, it will block the marking. So this one is the coil motor. And don't heat it too much, these pins. If the soldering isn't working out, quit it and try it again in a couple of seconds, because these are very sensitive to heat and it will bend in all funny angles. You won't get the connector in there anymore. So that's one, but coil motor, I'm going to write that down somewhere. The order of these things. I have some paper. Is this writable? L M 12 volt switch, and then the LED. So with the capacitor on the bottom left. So now, for a kit where providing an extra diode is a little bit too much, why are there all spare nuts and bolts, spare LEDs? I don't get that. I really don't understand that. Alright, well, all right, that's nasty. I will have to find a way for that. There are holes in here. Can I mount it somewhere on here? Is that a good idea? Is that why there are extra nuts and bolts? Are there extra holes in the middle? There is, but impossible to mount it on there. So, can I do this? Can I actually mount this on there? Probably can, right? Why not? But this is screw is way too short to fit through both plates, and these are exactly the same, so no, we cannot do that. To find in my own stock of screws to fix that. So for now I will be holding it, because I really 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 want to see if this works. Yeah, probably want to mount it on there somewhere like that. Let me find a zip tie. I'll be back in a moment. Now, I can't find a zip tie. I guess they're all gone, so I will hold it like this. Power cable, and make sure that the switch is in the off position, because this will probably spin a little bit more violent than the other kits. So right, let's make sure that it is spinning freely. All right, there we go. Is my power bank providing enough power? Probably not. Let's see if I can find this more powerful power bank. 2 amps should be sufficient, right? But nothing happens, right? Now I do smell a component, and that's probably this IC over here. Yes, it has some burn marks. Ooh, that smells bad. Now, that's going to need an investigation. I'll be back as soon as I fixed it. Now it is fixed, and you guys probably already saw what the problem was. I should have seen it too. It was too easy. And I even wrote it down. I said 12 volts. And what did I do? I plugged in a 5 volt power supply, 5 volt power bank. So I cut off the connector, the socket, because, well, I don't have these cables laying around for 12 volts. So yeah, I just hooked up my power supply. I extended the wires a little bit because they were too short, and probably to save some money with the wires. We Dutch have the name for being cheap, but the guys who made this kit, yeah. Well, enough said about that. I'm going to turn it on because it works. Yeah, but I need to hold it because this is quite heavy. When I turn it on and don't hold it, this entire thing will spin. So I will have to hold it, or you have to mount it on something. But for now, I'm going to hold it. Let's see that my fingers are not being hit, because this thing turns violently, absolutely. So there we go. And you can probably also hearing making it a lot of noise, because, well, it's generating quite a bit of wind. But there you can see, I don't know if you can see it from the top view, it is displaying all kinds of Chinese words, and I can change it with the remote, anything. Now it is, the time is spinning on the inside, and probably the date, and still the text going around at the outside. I'm pressing the 2 button, generates another Chinese text on the outside and images on the inside. And probably the pause button. Oh, the pause button only works for the outside. But now it's displaying images on the inner circle. Let's see what the 3 button does. More images. Oh, now it is doing some slideshow of still images. The 4 button. It is displaying an animation. I really do want to turn this to so you can see it. I probably need to turn off the lights to make it even better visible for you, because this probably, yeah, this does look like shit, and probably can turn off my lights with this remote too. So let me try that. There we go. And camera is probably not in focus. I'll try to touch it. Now, okay, let's go over some more. 5 button, 6 button does some more. 9 button. Oh, now it is displaying images on the outer circle. Yeah, I'm not going to pick it up because I don't want to lose any fingers. It is absolutely violently turning around. This is the 9. Oh, it's now just displaying animations on both sides. So I'm going to find a spot. Well, I might just do that in the next video when I demo it and program it with other images. I'll find a good spot, just like I did with the Canton Tower, to display how this thing looks and how it works. But for now it works, and I'm going to turn it off because my left hand is getting cold. So let me turn on the light again. The 1 button on this remote, probably. There we go. Right, works fine. Had to extend the wires, but overall, a nice kit. And next video, I'm going to try to reprogram it. Don't know if I'm going to do it within a couple of days, but I will reprogram it and give a full demonstration of the working of this kit. For now, thanks for watching.